yes, all let thy King be lifted Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna in the Hosanna.
Hosanna.
Father, we exalt thy name
in the highest.
Let the King be lifted up. Hosanna. Jesus, at the center of it all. Jesus, at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it's always been, will always be you, Jesus. Jesus, at the center. Jesus, at the center of my life. Jesus, be the center of my life. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, be the center.
Jesus, be the center of my life. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus.
Sing Jesus.
Jesus.
Nothing else matters. Nothing in this world will do. The center, and everything revolves around you, Jesus.
You,
from my heart to the heavens, Jesus, be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. Say,
from my heart.
It's all about you.
Yes, it's all about you.
From my heart to the heavens, Jesus, be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. For from my heart to the heavens. Jesus be the center. It's all about you.
All about you.
Yes, it's all about
from my heart.
You. From my heart
or
to
the
heavens. Jesus be the center. It's all about
yes,
you.
It's all about
yes, it's all about
from my heart.
It's
all about you.
Yes, it's all about
from my heart.
From my heart
to the heaven.
Jesus be the
center.
It's all about you,
Lord.
Yes, it's all about you.
Father, we give you all the glory and honor for you deserve. It is from the bottom of our hearts, oh Father, that we worship your name. We give you all the glory, our lives, Father, everything that we are. It is all because of you, my Master. We are not standing on our own. We do not live by our own power, Lord. But we live because of your grace, my Master. We give you all the honor, we give you all the praise, for you deserve it all. Lord, it's all about you. Not unto us, Father, but it is you, O King of glory. It is you, my Master. Kwagala kwo kumpitiriteko ngakulonze ngakunze nnyo okwakuleta kunsi kuno okutufiira omusayi gwe wayiwa ekologosa ogwo gwe gukuma bulijjo ogwo gwe gukuma okwagala kwo
kumpitiriddeko
nga kulungi
nga
okwakuleta
kwakuleta kunsi kuno okutufiira
ddala omusayi gwo omusayi Gambo to Yesu Mwemuri Amanyi Agoge Gakuma Bulito Agoge Gakuma
Bulito
Agoge
Gakuma.
Katonda omulungi, tukwebaza Katonda ow'ekisa, tukwebaza Katonda ow'amaanyi, tukwebaza omukulu ow'entiisa, omukulu ow'emirembe, kabaka w'abakabaka era omukama w'abakama. Twebaza ekisa kyo, twebaza omukono gwo ogw'amaanyi, twebaza obulokozi bwo, twebaza obukuumi bwo, twebaza okuganja kw'otutaddeko, twebaza, twebaza, twebaza Mukama. Tweyanza ssebo omulungi kubanga tetwategeera na kutegeera nti n'olwayo tunaabeerawo naye olw'enteekateeka z'Omukama otuleseewo n'olwaleero. Weebale kutukuuma, weebale kutukweka, weebale kutugabirira, weebale kutulabirira, webale tusa mchua wati rocho ne mchisikilize checho bulamu ne tubanga tukweke duwa mulinye rie chitibu ereli omuwendo omunji abatukili mwebadukida ne wabela abalamu tweyanza Katonda wafe tweyanza okubango tuwaine chisano wailo kuisa wedo boziri enjiri lituke erio bulamu wabantu lituke rie mitima jabantu liwaguze liitemu libotole liingire limenye bisenge liingire mitima lijema ama inja iteke mnyama lifula abantu bo abana bo bwakabaka bwakatonda so sabana abechizikiza lijja bantu muchizikize chikutenyo libalete mukutangala ko kwechitalo lijja bantu muchisikirize chokufalileta abantu mubulamo obwechitalo ai Katonda wange toyanzi sole dobozi ne lyenjiri eransa mo kama oliwa amanyi eransa mo kama olifukirira oligabiri oliwa mafuta mulinye eri Yesu Kristo mwana wa Katonda abero mulamu otuwe chisacho ayi kabaka waba kabaka nga tutusako baganda bafenga tutusako abantu bedobozi lyenjiri leka mukama wange liwulikike nga lya mugaso liwulikike nga lileeta obulamu liwulikike nga lileeta emirembe liwulikike nga lizaamu amaanyi abanafuye liwulikike nga liyimusa abanaku ku lubungo liwulikike nga lijja abantu mukama wange munfuufu nga libatuuzaamu n'abalangira liwulikike nga lisitula abalwadde ku bitanda nga libafuula abalamu eddoboozi ly'enjiri liwulikike ayi mukama wange nga lireeta essuubi ery'obulamu baggwamu essuubi liwulikike nga lireeta emirembe ery'obulamu baggwamu emirembe liwulikike nga lisumulula abasibe eddoboozi ly'enjiri liwulikike nga lijja bannamwandu mu nnaku yaabwe ne baamulekwa mukama wange mu mbeera yaabwe ey'obulumi liwulikike nga lireeta obulamu mu bulamu bw'omuntu obadde buggwerera mu linnya lya Yesu omwana wa Katonda omulamu eddoboozi ly'enjiri liwulikike nga lireeta essuubi eri eggwanga lyaffe nga lireeta essuubi eri ensi yonna nga ligenda mu nkomerero zonna ez'ensi nga lireetawo essuubi erijja mu linnya lya Yesu Kristo omwana wa Katonda omulamu eddoboozi ly'enjiri mukama wange liwulikike nga liddamu okuggulawo mukama wange byali byaggalwawo nga liddamu okutema ekkubo mukama watali kkubo nga liyisa emigga mu ddungu nga liyisa ekkubo mu lukoola eddoboozi ly'enjiri liwulikike nga lireeta obulamu obw'obulokozi mu bulamu bw'omuntu omu mu kaseera kano atuukiddwako ekigambo kino atuukiddwako eddoboozi lino eddoboozi ly'enjiri liwulikike mukama eddoboozi ly'enjiri liwulikike lireeta emirembe lireeta amaanyi tukuwa ekitiibwa tukuwa matendo mu Kristo Yesu mukama waffe amen mukama yebazibwe
praise the Lord
mukama yebazibwe nnyo
praise the Lord
twagala okwebaza Katonda nnyo nnyini ddala
we want to bless the name of the Lord indeed
lwekisa mukama akyatuwadde
for the grace that the Lord has given us for the protection that the Lord has placed upon our lives, for the mighty hand of the Lord that has taken care of us, we bless the name of the Lord. We glorify the name of Jesus. We greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And we bless the name of the Lord who has positioned you even for today. When you're still living, when you still confess that Jesus is Lord, the glory and honor belongs to him. Let us go into the word of the Lord. Exodus 33. Exodus 33 from verse 12. Exodus 33 from verse 12.
Tusoma Bible eyo Luganda. Musa n'agamba Mukama nti, laba ondagira nti twala abantu bano n'otonganya kumanya gw'onootuma wamu nange. Naye wayogera nti nkumanya erinnya era walaba ekisa mu maaso gange.
Then Moses said to the Lord, see, you said to me, bring up these people, but you have not yet, but You have not let me know whom you send with me. Yet you have said, I know your name, and you have also found grace in my sight.
Kale kakano nkwegayiride. Bwembanga nalabe chisa muma sogo. Ondagama kubogo. Nkumanye. Ndiokenda be chisa muma sogo. Edalo oza ngegwangalino. Bantubo.
Now, therefore, I pray, if I have found grace in your sight, show me now your way, that I may know you, and that I may find grace in your sight, and consider that this nation is your people.
Mukama nadamu Musa na yogera nti, amaso gange galigenda nawe, nawe ndikuwa okuumula.
And he said, my presence will go with you, and I'll give you rest.
Olwa kuminetan. Namugamba nti amaso go bwegata agende nga nange tototwala okuva wano.
Then he said to him, if your presence does not go with us, do not bring us up from here.
Kubanga kiritegeerebwa kitya nga nze nalaba ekisa mu maaso go nze n'abantu bo. Si kye kiriva kitegeerebwa kubanga ogenda naffe n'okwawulwa ne twawulibwa nze n'abantu bo mu bantu bonna abali mu maaso g'ensi.
For how then will it be known that your people and I have found favor in your sight, except you go with us? So we shall be separate, your people and I, from all the people who are upon the face of the earth.
Mukama n'agamba Musa nti, era n'ekyo ky'oyogedde ndikikola. Kubanga walabe ekisa mu maaso gange nange nkumanya erinnya.
So the Lord said to Moses, I'll also do this thing that you have spoken, for you have found grace in my sight, and I know you by name.
Nayogera nti nkwegayiridde ondage ekitiibwa kyo. Nayogera nti nayisa obulungi bwange bwonna mu maaso go, era n'atendera erinnya lya Mukama mu maaso go, era namukwatirwanga ekisa gwe nakwatirwanga ekisa, era namusaasiranga gwe nasaasiranga.
And he said, please show me your glory. Then he said, I'll make all my goodness pass before you, and I'll proclaim the name of the Lord before you. I'll be gracious to whom I'll be gracious, and I'll have compassion on whom I'll have compassion.
Mukama yebazibwe nyo.
Praise the Lord.
Mukama yebazibwe.
Praise the Lord.
Twasaba omwoyo mutukuva atukulemberere mu kigambo kino.
May the Holy Spirit guide us through this word.
Olwalero.
Today.
Njala kutandika n'omutwe guno ogw'enjiri.
I want to start with this topic of the gospel.
Mudobozi y'enjiri jatandika ne theme eno simanyi banga ina amalanga njogerako.
Under this major topic of the voice of the gospel, I want to speak about this theme, which I don't know how long I'll speak about
it.
I want to speak about the journey of salvation.
Olugendo lw'obulokozi.
The journey of salvation.
Ekigambo kyokka olugendo.
The word in itself, the journey.
Nze amakulu gaakyo newankubadde n'ensi erina amakulu g'ekigambo olugendo.
Me, the meanings I got, even though the word has got different meanings as well.
Naye nange nyina amakulu agange gempulira omwoyo gampa.
But I also feel my own meanings that I feel the Spirit gives me.
Olugendo.
The journey.
Kitegeeza ekintu kyonna.
It means anything.
Ng'oggye ku Katonda.
Away from God. And I from the angels in heaven. Even Jesus after ascending to heaven. Any other thing.
Olugendo kitegeeza nti ky'ekintu amakulu g'olugendo ky'ekintu ekiyina we kitandikira ne we kikoma.
The meaning of the journey, it is something that has got a beginning point and an end point.
Aha. Newankubadde yensi interpretation ya yegamba nti olugendo kakutambula ng'oyina ova mu kifo ekimu ogenda mu kirala.
Though the interpretation of the word says that it is moving from one place to another.
Abalala abensi bakidefining nga bagamba nti olugendo kwe kutambula awantu awawanvu nga walimu n'ebintu n'embeera enzibu oba ebintu ebitawaanya mu lugendo.
Other people define it in the world that it is embarking on a long distance journey which has got different hurdles along the way.
Abana basi bawakanya.
I do not
adjure.
And we do not have any separation But me, I want to summarize it into something that moves from one place to another place. It is something with the beginning point and the end point. It is something with the beginning point and the end point. Even if it's a person, even if it's an animal, even if they are birds, even if it's a tree, even if they are these creatures that the Lord created, and even the things that the creatures manufactured, the seat that I'm sitting on, it has got its start point when it was still
new,
and now it is transitioning into the specs I'm putting on. I got them from when they
are
new, and they have got its expiry date. The clothes you're putting on, it has got a beginning point and an end point. But even the life we possess, it has got a beginning point and an end point.
So what definition chevegenange egere etema atema neganti no bulamu bw'omubiri lugendo.
That is why the definition tries to break it down, that even this life of a person is a journey.
Waliwo lugendo lw'obulamu bw'omubiri.
There is a journey of this life of the flesh.
Waliwo lugendo lw'ebirowoozo.
There is a journey of the mind.
Olugendo lw'ebifaananyi.
There is a journey of different images.
Oba imaginations. Americans.
Me have never been to America.
Neewogera Washington nze nkuba nakafana ine njira bawele.
But when they speak about Washington, I try to imagine and see where exactly it is.
Nze natuke Kampala sina bako jayo.
Me go to Kampala before coming to stepping to Kampala.
Nga abansuka batu nimiza Kampala ojiraba ne weri no laba nengirija kola no akwade botuka yola balwe njawulo.
The people who came to Kampala before us, by the time they were telling us Kampala, you would imagine how it looks like, but by the time you get here, you see a
difference.
So our journey started from there. A person embarks on their journey from the day they are conceived in their mother's womb. When they are still just
unmarried.
And then they become into a sperm.
Na fuko musai.
And then they become
into blood. Lugendo.
Oh, that is a journey.
Musai ne kuvamo omuntu.
And then the blood out of it comes a
ne
person.
Nebo omuntu no chiwumbe chiri awo taina maso taina nyindo taina kamwa chitu.
But this person is just an image which has got no shape or any eyes or mouth.
Neolo kwa katonda ino buinza na amanyi awali amaso na ateka ola ama yao amaso negavayo amatu negavayo nyindo nezivayo maneguvayo.
But because he's all powerful and is able, he places every part of the body into its position. And then this baby embarks on the journey of the 9 months, and they come out of their mother's womb when they are passed. And they take care of them. They take care of them well. And they are taken and held very fragile. Nobody abuses them. Nobody calls them a
child.
But as they continue on the journey, they start seeing different spots and even shortcomings on this person, and they start even abusing them. They give birth to this baby when they have a head, but by the time they embark on their journey, along the journey, the head turns out into a big head.
But
by the time they are just being born, they are all just pampered. Oh, the baby. So the journey has got different situations that go on, changing a person as the journey continues. So the journey is always long. And in the journey, there must be people who are on your side who support you on walking out this journey. It is very hard to walk a journey when you're alone. When I read a certain article in my phone which was saying, if you want to go fast, you can go alone. Uh-huh. But if you want to go far, uh-huh, then you can go with other people.
Aha, we vale nyo. Ochinyo bulungi maka. Boba yagala ogenda amangu yagala kwangua oyinzo genda weka.
If you want to go fast, you can go alone.
Ne wala utuke wala oyino genda naba abantu abalala.
But if you want to go far, you need other people to accompany.
Ebyo byonna byonna ne bifaana ng'ebyo byonna bitegeeza lugendo.
All the things that are like that, they all mean the journey.
Byonna bitegeeza lugendo.
They all mean the journey.
Mukama yebazibwe nnyo.
Praise be to our God.
You can say Martin Luther inacha yogera Martin Luther King Jr. inacha yogera ku bintu biko atano lugendo. Na gamba nti bobos eido boya vula.
Martin Luther King Jr. spoke some article about the journey and he said whether you're crawling
obo tambula
or you're walking
oba we walula
or you're just dragging yourself,
don't care
tambula about that. Don't worry about
that.
So long as you're in motion, it means that our entire life, even if you just sit in one place,
you're doing a transition.
Just know, even if you sit in one position, in one chair, and you say, I'll be here, just know where you are, you are still in motion. So there are many words that are mean or explain this
word.
And people can differentiate or define the word in this journey, there are many other things that are involved in this language of the lawyers are called different counts. There is a major case, but there are also additional cases. For example, if somebody murdered the other, and after murdering, they stole even their phone, or they stole even their computer, or they stole even their money. So they do not just read it out and they say it is murder. So they read out for you that you murdered someone
as a principal case.
And then they add on other small cases called the
counts.
On that day, you stole a phone from the other person. On that very day, they said that on that very person that you murdered, you stole their computer. They do not bask them at once. So even the journey has got those small
characters.
In the journey that we move in, there are different counts or small issues of the
journey.
Let me say that the principal bit of the journey is life. Our entire journey, we embark on it, or we start on it when it's not going on. Because it started from the Garden of Eden when it was already defiled and already corrupted. Our ancestors started on it and they started it. In the journey of the person, according to God, there was no death. But because somebody embarked on the journey and they spoiled the journey, and the condition was, when you spoil it, you will die. So our journey did not have a beginning and the end. It had to be that we had to leave all the days and move all the but when death came in, then we got an end point of the journey. Of the journey that we are in. And death came in. Now the situation changed. Now in every way, in whichever way we wanted, we needed somebody who can help us in the journey so that we can end well. Because this journey is taking us safari. You cannot embark on it alone and
you
need somebody to support you
kati,
and to give you company. And Moses realized that he cannot embark on this journey alone. He had tried it before. He had seen the problems. As you have also seen the problems. And you have realized the problems in the
journey.
It is not easy when you are embarking on it alone. You can die along the way. You can die quickly. You may not get exactly where you want to go. You don't have any guarantee that you get to where you want to go. I was looking out, I was seeing a young man who was going from Busia to Kamuli on foot. He started his journey and he was just seeing it is and he was even joking. And he said, me, I cannot wait for the quarantine to keep me in this place. And he said, it's only a one day journey. Actually, not even a one day. It's just a half of the journey, of the day, I will be to Kamuli.
Baganda, when I get to Kamuli, I will be to Kamuli.
And they told him, you cannot walk more than 120 kilometers in one journey. And he said, me, I can.
Naja.
And he decided to walk the journey. He did not even walk 25 kilometers. And then he realized that his legs were starting and it was not easy to put
him in the shoes.
Now they saw him again. He was sitting somewhere and then he was all overwhelmed. It is very hard to walk on this journey of life. I know what I'm speaking. Some of you have tried it and it has failed. That's why I told you that in this journey of life, there is a many counts. For example, marriage. In the journey of life, the journey of marriage is also a count. You realize that when as you're moving, you need someone to embark or to support. That is what is
more.
And then you see children also coming in. And they're also part of the journey. Now remember, you have got now to a place. And they have stopped you when they have things along the way. And they tell you, help us take these things to Kampala. But when you have a pickup, so now they have given you a container. Whether you like it or not, the pickup that was running at a pace at a fast rate, it will start going when the speed is reduced. The speed will be reduced because the weight is now too heavy. And you get to a place. And you find someone who has got two sacks of banana. And then you load them again. The pickup will fill the way. Who was going up the mountain when you're in number four, you need now to put in gear number one. The more you grow in this life,
loaded.
You realize that as you embark on your journey, that the journey starts being a luzitowa ngo tikidwe bintu bingi.
Ozitowa.
You become heavy.
Ati chichoko lango muntu omugezi.
So what do you do as a wise
person? Oina kumanya anti netaka yo muntu wamanya yizo kunyamba olugendo ono tutuse bulungi.
You need to realize that I need somebody more powerful that can help me and support me so that I may end my journey.
Ezo chendi kwa Oluganda abalokoka nabatanaloka ngamulye muli enje no lwalero abajiraba.
That is what I'm speaking about for you who are saved and those who are not yet saved, but when you're listening and watching this gospel, that in this journey you need the Lord. In this journey there is a lot of
weight.
So we have been walking
amid
is driving on a highway, and then now we found the
coronavirus.
When it also wants us to die, it is so heavy. The coronavirus is heavy for some people. When you need somebody who can enhance or support you with more power. In this journey, there is a lot of slippery. When the car you're driving is your life, when it requires a high gear.
A high gear, reserve gear.
When it requires that reserve gear. When these normal gears are filled, when you need to insert in the
drive,
and then you fill the car when it is jacked into its own power. My car's got a button. Every time I'm driving, and I feel I want to overtake a car, but it is running at a speed. There is a button I press. And then I feel the car when it is jacked into its power, and then I feel it in myself that I can overtake it. Even the journey of
life.
Because there are different mountains, there are slippery places, there are different situations and many different things. We must have the four-wheel
reserve.
In the language of the people who drive the cars, we call them the four-wheel
drive. Four-wheel drive.
We call them the four-wheel drive.
Button.
We need to have a button we press.
In this life.
In the journey of salvation. You need the Lord. Write it down. You need the Lord. You need the Lord in this journey. So that you can strengthen your journey to move when it is
moving.
Even in a situation which is slippery, where you can place some place, where you can place in a certain
place,
and you pass through some places where some people
start.
And then they ask you, how did you manage to go through? How did you manage to do that? Ladies and gentlemen, there is no any other way we can do that. Aside, lest you have the Lord. Lest you have the Lord. You need the Lord. Now, in the Lord, there are different buttons which
press.
There is what we call the Holy Spirit. You need the Holy Spirit. After getting salvation,
the
salvation we get in our Lord Jesus, then we get the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is a
person
that helps us in slippery places. The person that helps us in the
barren
waves. It is a button.
The person that helps us in the storm.
It's a button that helps us in different
problems.
The Holy Spirit. You cannot embark on this journey because it is going that far, and you want to get there when you're successful. When you don't have the Spirit of God, and you tell me that you finish it now, it will be hard for you. And it is very hard to tell me that you get to your destination.
Prematurely.
People have died, but you
want to
die. People have died along the way. People have died without clinching to their
dreams.
And their big visions. People have died when they have got
dreams
and great visions. But they did not come to
pass.
Because they didn't know what exactly to use to walk their journey. To get into their dreams. To get into their visions. Let us take Moses. He spoke in this word. And he's saying that I hear you're telling me to go. He said, God, you're telling me to go. Yes, you're telling me that
we should go.
But you're not telling me who are we going with. I pray that the Lord will help us that this secret that Moses had with
you,
that you have it in your life. Any journey that the Lord is not part of, it is impossible. Any journey that you embark on in the journey called salvation, not the bus called
And he rebuked the storm and told
it.
Let me tell you, brother.
Yes,
you
are in a solution.
Is Jesus who has got a solution?
Yes, you are in a solution.
Is Jesus who has got a solution in the journey of your life?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And Moses asked the Lord, I like this.
Twali mu devotion ya waka.
We're in the devotions, the family devotion. Some 2 days back. We're discussing about Psalms 119. It has got 18 parts. It has got 176 verses has got 18 parts. Every night,
to discuss,
we discuss two different. And after reading them, we task every person to tell us what has been their take home. But there is a part we are to read. When David was speaking words to the Lord, and we try to discuss around that. And there was a suggestion or an idea of the spirit that
came.
And I told the brethren that sometimes
we pray,
not in a good way when we are before the Lord. And we pray hypocritical prayers. And we don't pray exactly what is within us. It came from someone who was saying that there is a situation I was going through and I felt I didn't have even a prayer to make. They were telling the friend the story or all about this and they say that I don't have even a prayer to make. And the Holy Spirit brought an
idea.
Even the word itself that they spoke to the friend, it is also a prayer. Instead of telling it to the friends, if they would have told it to the Lord.
David.
We had read a place where David was asking the Lord that how many are my days? I've sought out for you, but I can't find you. I am like asking. skin that has been placed in tar.
Kati abalokole benaku zino as a salat to the saba.
So the born agains of these days, we don't pray.
Tuli hore nyo.
Ah, tuli batukuku.
Tuli bulungi nyo.
We are so well.
Eya festivity.
Our things
kati
are not
fair. But we say we are talking mukama.
So when we make such prayers, we are abusing the Lord.
Niate.
But
sala.
But even those entire words is
actually a deep prayer.
Because you're speaking out what is at the depth of your heart and your prayer. But somebody comes when they're heavy laden. They have many things to pray for. And then
he starts saying that Jesus is so great, Lord. You are to do so great. What you do, Jesus.
And the Lord looks at you and says, what you're seeing and what you're saying is
not what I'm saying.
Within you, I'm seeing a lot of sorrow.
So, Katonda walanga echitafe.
As if God is our Father. Be free to him. Speak to him as a child speaks to the father.
By the way, there
are some things that I don't want to speak about in my life when I'm speaking them to my
You
will not hear me in a long while testifying about getting a car. The Holy Spirit has told me many things. And I look at Mark, my son. And I try to imagine if Mark wants a shoe to go back to school. And he comes and tells me that my shoe is worn out. I need a new shoe. And I buy for him a new shoe. How many times does Mark come to a church and testify, not even about the shoe, but I've been
assured?
Mark enjoys chapati and enjoys bread. Those things he
uses.
He's so free, he can find me when I'm resting on my bed, and he tells me that we want something to eat. But can you? Do you find it right if Mark, my son, comes on such a screening?
Now, testifies
and says,
"Daddy,
Daddy bought for me a soda." This man must be a very hard man if his son is testifying about the soda. If a soda is a miracle to Mark, even the heavens, they just when we say that in heaven, they are also surprised. They're like, are they testifying about this God or they have another God? Are you understanding what I'm saying? Because those are miracles, it is bread for children. The Bible says that miracles is bread for children. Children, they don't have to testify that the Lord built for me a house. I give God the glory who bought for me a new suit. The people of the world,
as a stranger God,
they applaud
because
the stranger God
deep makes your sense.
But when we go deep, even the Lord turns aside and is like, and he starts even examining the DNA.
Father,
when you say out Abba Chitafe, do you mean that? Because what you're saying, it is a miracle. And to my children, it's a
miracle.
That is not a miracle. So how do you call it a miracle? What would have called miracles and then they make the Lord happy? That's not what you call miracles. Let's learn to give true and right testimony.
Miracle.
When you lead someone to Christ and then you bring them into the house of the Lord, you know what you have done? You have embarked on the
journey.
And then you've gone to hell. And you've fought with the devil. And then you have
made them
lose out on this soul and you've
built it to
the
kingdom of
God. You're coming from the kingdom. Praise the Lord.
Musa.
Moses speaks to the Lord as somebody speaks to the Father. He realizes secret. And he's telling you,
How do I go?
Who should I go? We told the Lord, if you don't tell me that we are going with you, I'm swearing to you. I'm swearing to my father
Abraham.
We shall not go away from here.
We
shall not move an inch. If you don't tell me that we are going together with
you,
how many times have you sought out for the Lord so that
you can go?
How many times have you considered that moving and embarking on the journey with the Lord
is not
the Lord is not even part of the people
you
have your friends, the cocoons
that
you have, even those who have cast that support. There are things that you lean on. David
said
that I lifted my eyes upon the mountain. That is where always my hope comes from. Sometimes the mountains are people.
Then
my salvation is in us. Don't worry, so and so do that for us. Sometimes the people that we have trusted, they are
wild
and disappointed. Because the journey that we are in, we need somebody to move. And he gave us the car or the carrier called salvation. And he gave us a driver called the Holy Spirit. Those things and then we think that we shall embark on our journey with just so long as I have
marked
so long as the pastor is praying so and so will defend
me.
Even if they arrest me, the pastor will come and
stand.
There is no anywhere where people think that the Lord will do it for them. Even if we say it out, we say it to be out of what
to come,
but we don't mean it. We don't mean it.
Verbally.
Just in bigger.
Or
I'm sick. Don't worry, the Lord will heal me.
Verbally.
Just in bigger.
No power in there.
No power. No power. No, the Lord will
work.
Even you take us out of
the
bigambo, bigambo.
Join a relationship with Katonda.
Join an kolagana na Katonda.
Join a connection yona na ye.
You don't have any connection with
the Lord. Nekuloro korego kumanyi.
Even on the roll calling of the heavens, they don't know you. They don't know you. Because the Lord is just. It is just
verbal.
The Lord says that they just respect me with their lips. But their hearts are far away from
me.
Their hearts are now also
far away.
They gave up
on
me. They didn't consider me to be their God. But let's learn from the servant
of
God. And
he
told the Lord that I want to move
on.
We cannot end and get to the end of this journey without you. Brethren, let the journey. Let's include the Lord. Let our journey. Let the Lord
move
on for us. In the name of
Jesus Christ.
Psalms 37. Verse 5.
No rabbi de mesat.
And 23.
Agamba buat.
Says like this.
Olugendolo.
That your journey.
Oluiring is sa kumukama. Erabuato banalutu kirizanga.
Entrust your journey or commit your journey or your ways to the Lord, and that's how they come to pass.
Olugendolo.
Your journey.
Oluiring is sa kumukama.
Commit them before the Lord.
Erabuato banalutu kirizanga.
And that's how they come to pass. So who do you commit your journey unto? Listen to the words that the Lord responded to
him.
He told him that I know you by name, and I called you your mind, and I affirm you without a doubt in this journey. I'm going to move with you.
That was wonderful.
Chari chamanyi nyo.
Eyo assurance ya manyi nyo.
Obo bukakafu.
Bofuna nga chance mukama naganti nawe ngenda kutambula nawe.
When you get a chance and the Lord tells that I'm going to move with you.
Weba zinyo mukama olwecho.
Give God the glory for that.
Olugendo.
Your journey.
Lwetaga mukama.
Requires the Lord.
Olugendo.
Your journey.
Lwetaga mu echombo kibaito obulokozi.
They need the ship that is called salvation.
Olugendo.
Your journey.
Lwetaga mu pilot.
They need omuvuzi.
Weba yita.
That is called
Moyo Mtukufu.
The Holy Spirit.
Olugendo.
Your journey.
Lwetaga mu tools.
Request
over facilitation.
Over entanda jokoza.
That is called
the word of God.
Olugendo.
Your journey.
Lwetaga mu kam.
Needs the Lord.
Awatalije.
Without him.
Uja kumenya nyo.
It will really
Olunyido
be
so. Olabili mwesatu. Olabili mwesatu. Lusuma ujama.
Verse 23 in Psalms 37. It says that steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. And he delights in his way. Have you heard that?
Olugendo lw'omuntu lunyezebwa Mukama. Era asanyukire kkubo lye. Katonda. Yasobola okunyeza olugendo.
It's only the Lord that can.
Tewali lugendo lw'ogenda kutambula n'olugusa.
There is no journey that you embark on and you finish.
Okutuusa nga Mukama alukutambulidde.
Until the Lord has moved it.
Lujja kwangujira.
It will be easy for you.
Luwewuka nyo.
It will be light.
Atobera kushuwadde.
And you'll be on a sure deal.
Naye musango buzibona muko.
And even if you find any hard along.
Kastabanga mulyato mwali.
So long as he's in the journey or in the
boat. You are more than a conqueror.
Oli muwanguzi n'okukirawo.
You are more than a conqueror.
Oli muwanguzi n'okukirawo.
Kastabanga mulyato mwali.
So long as he's in the boat.
Njagala kakasembula muko.
I want you to be sure.
Obanga mulyato Mukama mwali.
Examine your life and check if that is if you are sure about that, you're going to get well to
wherever
you
go.
And you'll get that
successful.
And you'll get that successful. Is there any dream you have? That you're carrying? Are you a servant of the Lord? You have a vision you're carrying? Your ministry you're carrying? The journey requires the Lord. Away from that. You're going to see people casting a ministry. And they started long way back. Others are in America.
Abambali mu Europe kubyeyo.
Nenga
baba mu Uganda ngabaweleza bakatunda
baamani. They are outside laboring, but when they left Uganda, when they are servants of the Lord.
Olugendo baluddukamu.
They ran away from the journey.
Bali mu lugendo lwabo.
They are now on their own journey.
Ni wankubadde mumbaine biro baina enjogerika anti katunda yabatumayo.
Though some people have a slogan that they usually say.
Sina chizibu nacho chisoboka nachecho.
Me have no problem, it is also possible.
Nika kasanga chitufu ya kutuma.
But be sure that it's the Lord that sent you.
Era weto lotu ne wantu woli kusawazi.
And try and examine wherever you are.
Tunuli ya wantu woli kusawazi.
Examine the place where you are.
Ola wawanga bikoto demo kama ya bikutuma.
And make sure that what is around you is the Lord who gave you that as your package.
Wasulo mukaze ya Uganda.
You forsook your wife in Uganda.
Nabana.
And your children.
No gano from Europe.
And you got another one in Europe.
Gano from America.
And you got another one in America.
No mukazo malale Canada.
You have another wife in Canada. Look at the things around
you.
The things around
you. Okakasoba dala mukama yebi yakutu maybe.
And then you know and be sure that's the word the Lord sent you to.
Oyinza okumaliza ngo yambiddwa nnyo.
You may at the end of the day be helped so much.
Bible yegamba.
The Bible says.
Nti dayono eje wasula okwagala okwasoka.
Go and look for where you left.
Ndoza kubikuli wasula 3.
Revelation chapter number 3.
Nonya kubikuli
go and examine why you forsook your first love. And you go back.
The Bible says
that you have to go back and you fetch your first
love.
I want to give you counsel today, my friend. That if you had casted your journey somewhere, though you had moved and gone at a far, those things happen. We have ever driven cars and
anything.
And then we got lost.
Ne tuvuga kilometers ezisuka makumi asatu nga tubuze.
And we drove more than 30 kilometers.
Ne we twagenda okubuuliza omuntu gwe twazokulaba tugamba nti kuba mwali sudde wala.
But when we try to ask from someone, he told us, oh, you
are going to where you're going.
Where you're going,
connection you na.
There is no even connection
ne
to where you're going. What you need to do is
one.
Just turn around and go back where you're coming
from.
30 kilometers from where
you are,
and you find a junction, and a junction will give you the right way.
Bible tugamba bulungi nyo,
and the Bible tells us
where.
Go back into the
junction
and ask for the old path. The people who are in the journey
will.
There is a time of getting
lost.
But let me give you counsel. Do not allow to get lost. Do not allow to get lost. Where you understand your
truth.
Just stand from there.
No matter obulumi bogendo kuita mo kudda yokutandika olugendo jiwarusula.
Regardless of the pain you go through when you're going back to where you had got
lost. Kisingo kubulira ddala.
It is better off than getting lost.
Dozo tegedde bulu oluga.
So you've got to understand.
Lachima kama atakuwa mukisoro wale.
Let us say the Lord bless you.
Tujja kutandikira wenchange kisacham kama bwechiri.
We shall start from there as the grace of the
Lord.
When he gives us the grace tomorrow, we shall start. And then we shall start upon the
word
of the gen of the but I beg you, because of the Spirit of the Lord, if you feel like in the journey that you
are,
when you feel like you're getting lost, make your journey straight again. Make your way straight again. There is a word you can do.
Abazungu,
the white people,
bachita sorry.
They say, oh, sorry.
Abaganda,
the Baganda,
bachita ansonywa.
They say, I'm sorry.
Abanyankole,
the Banyankole,
bachita ansasira.
They say, have mercy on me. It doesn't have many letters. When you do that before the Lord, it has a lot of power. So I give you counsel. If you still have a chance, do that. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. So Lord Jesus, thank you for the word I've heard of the journey. And even me. Indeed, I'm in the journey. I'm walking. But I realized. But I got lost. But I thought of going
back.
It is so far. And I chose to just go. Now I'm just walking. Just astray. I don't even know where I'm going. My hope is lost. I cannot go where I was at first. The first grace I already
received.
The first peace I lost. The first love I lost. I am there just like an empty
place.
But Lord, this word has brought me back. And I'm starting to repent. I pray you forgive me. And I choose to change. To go back in the junction where I had forsaken my first love. And I'll embark on my journey again. Forgive me, Jesus. Though I made you go back on the cross, I pray that you have mercy upon me. I pray that you have mercy upon me. I've gotten to know that in the journey I'm in, you are not part of it. You had already forsaken me. There is a place where I'd left you. There is a place where I'd forsaken you. There is a place where I'd forsaken
you.
There is a place where I jumped out of salvation. But I'm coming back to you. I pray that you forgive me. You have mercy and you forgive me. And you bring me back in the other place. As you brought back the child, the prodigal son, I pray that you bring me back to you. In this journey, I pray that I want to
move it,
and I want to bring it to completion when I'm successful.
Nyamba,
help me
that
this dream that you gave me, that I will bring it to completion well when you're with me. I pray that you move with me in this journey, and I pray that you are
found
me, that in this journey you are with me.
Nange.
And me, I'll be a victor
no,
and more than a conqueror. In the name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
May
God bless you.
May
God bless you.
Thank you
for listening to
the
message today. On this day, Sunday.
Third.
Omwezo ogwokutaano.
May.
Twebaza Katonda.
We bless the name of
Kalantini
the Lord. That our quarantine.
Egwako ennaku bbiri ezijja.
It is ending in 2 days. Okosa
encha.
In 2 days.
Tusubira.
We expect.
Tuwalo okusumulwa okwenjala ogenda okubeerawo.
There is going to be a release.
Nene we kunaate kubaddewo.
And if it does not happen to you.
Mukama afa anasigala
yemuka. Our God will remain to be God.
Yesu anasigala yemuka.
Jesus will remain to be God.
Tusigale nga tugondera amate ya government.
Just continuously obey the guidance of the government. Tusigala
tambulia
let's continuously move in what they
told us,
in the guidelines they gave us, and let's move in them in the name of Jesus, the Son of the Living
God.
If the Lord has still given us the grace to do something, may the Lord establish you, and may He give you the power to
overcome.
We pray that the hand of the Lord will be on your side, and you remain to be faithful in the word of God.
More
so you, the children of the
Lord,
we remain faithful in the word of God. And you give in your tithe. If the Lord has given you the money and
they are faithful,
give in your offering in your service of your house. And the Lord will remain when you have not cut Him short. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray that the grace of the Lord will be with you. The week you're entering in will be a week of divine
promises.
It will be a week of
ebere wiki yokutandika olugendo olulungi.
Ebere
wiki yokutereza ebyasoba.
It will be a week of making things right.
Mukama akole bulungi.
May the Lord do good to you.
Kwagala nyo.
I love you so much.
Sigadde nganze bizimu
ku Everest.
Freeman.
Sumba
ahiringa ina
worship center. Ane kisugu wa bigalo. In Kampala.
Mu Uganda.
In Uganda.
Kama bawo mukisa.
May God bless you.
Mulinya eliya Yesu.
In the name of our Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.